chance to meet David Oxtoby, an artist whose subjects are Half Past Three, and follows a Presley picture now, Double Trouble, our star movie. Now on BBC One from Arena, a portrait of a man who's not only a great Presley fan, but a very accomplished artist, The King and I.
Love me tender, love me sweet, never let me go. You have made my life, and I love you so. Love me tender, love me true, all my dreams fulfill. For my darling, I love you, and I
first turned on to Elvis as a teenager in the mid-50s. He's always been the king for me. But it was a serious bout of diabetes that really brought us together. Although I've been painting Elvis for years, it was only when I was really ill that I could afford to devote myself to it full time.
Love me tender, love me true, all my dreams fulfill.
I've done more pictures of Elvis Presley than anybody else. Well, it's a very easy image to use. It's a very sort of beautiful image in that way. And when you look at photographs of all that particular era, you know, I mean, his looks alone have carried him quite a long way, I guess.
Love me dear, tell me.
Presley's physical appearance was crucial in his career. In fact, his classical looks had a timeless quality about them. For example, this is a fairly free interpretation of John Cocteau and Picasso's rather stylized version of a Greek god, which is easily transferred into the boy king.
In 1964, at the age of 26, David Oxtoby became visiting professor at the Minneapolis Institute of Fine Art. He had just completed four outstanding years at the Royal Academy in London.
When I first arrived at the Academy, there was this very sort of dowdy sort of room, and I'd heard lots of rather doomy stories about the Academy. And I walked in, there was this sort of semicircular seats that one had to sit in with your drawing board and look at this little plinth with this awful model sat on top and this piece of rope that looked as though they used to participate in hangings or something there. And it felt a bit like that. It's very dowdy, very dungeony type of place. And I'm sat there, and I sat there for a couple of days, and I knew that I had 3 months' life drawing to do as a sort of probationary thing. And I was sat drawing this figure, and in a while this old guy came in with his sticks, and I thought, oh God, you know, I mean, I'd never stand it. And he walked up behind this sort of professional virgin-looking lady who was drawing this thing, and he said, don't know what you're trying to do, love, but it's like pissing against Niagara. And I thought, well, that's it, you know, I'm in, this is it, this is for me. And I settled in really well after that.